In this example, the figure shows a ball of mass m placed on the rough surface of a plank of mass 4m, which is placed on smooth ground. If plank is pulled by a horizontal force, F, we're required to find linear acceleration of plank and cylinder, if cylinder is not slipping on plank. In this situation, we just carefully analyze motion of the two bodies on applying a force F on the plank. Due to roughness, here a friction acts on it, and the same friction will act on the ball in opposite direction. In this situation we can state, as the cylinder is not slipping on the plank, that means it is in pure rolling. Then for the case of pure rolling we can say, it'll be moving with respect to plank in backward direction, with an angular acceleration alpha and an acceleration a1. And here we can state, for pure rolling of ball, which we treat as a sphere, we can write a1 is equal to r alpha. Here be careful that as we've taken pure rolling on plank, so a1 is the acceleration of ball with respect to plank. However, we can take the plank is moving forward with acceleration a2, so net acceleration of ball in forward direction can be written as a2 minus a1. From this equation, if we write equation of motion for plank, we can directly write F minus F is equal to 4ma. And for the ball, we can write the only force acting on it is friction. So friction we can write as small m into a2 minus a1. And here also I must write a2 because plank is moving with an acceleration a2. And if we add the two equations, we'll get F is equal to 5ma2 minus ma1. This expression we'll get. And if we write the equation of rotational motion for this ball, the only force acting on it is friction, and torque of which is providing the angular acceleration. So we can write FR is equal to I alpha, which can be written as 2 by 5 MR square, and alpha we can write A1 by R. Here R gets cancelled out and we get the value of friction to be 2 by 5 MA1. Now from these two equations, by substituting the value of F, it'll be 2 by 5, MA1 is equal to small MA2 minus small MA1. M gets cancelled out and by shifting this A1 to left hand side of equality, you can see that we'll get 2 by 5 plus 1 is 7 by 5. A1 is equal to A2, this relation we get here. So now in this situation, if we substitute the value of A2 over here, or A1 over here, as we're required to find the linear acceleration of plank, so A2 we've to find, we substitute value of A1 here, and from here we get F is equal to 5ma2 minus ma1. A1 we write 5 by 7 A2. From here on simplifying we get 5 minus 5 by 7. So this we write as 30 by 7 MA2. This is the result we get. From here we get the value of acceleration of plank as 7F upon 30M. That'll be the answer to our problem, which is the acceleration of plank that we just now calculated by writing equations of motion for plank and that of cylinder. For cylinder we've written one translatory motion equation, and other is the equation for rotational motion. So we handle the problem in the similar way that we've discussed, by using Newton's second law for translational motion as well as for rotational motion.